This video is going to be about electronic countermeasure, also known as ECM. An electronic countermeasure is a system designed to interfere with or disrupt an enemy's electronic equipment, such as radars or communication systems, in order to prevent them from effectively targeting or communicating with the fighter jet. There are various electronic countermeasure systems installed on fighter jets to protect against threats from enemy radar, missiles, and other electronic warfare systems. Radar warning receiver is considered to be an ECM system. In F-18, it is located at the top of the tail section, whereas in F-16, it is located at the bottom of the tail. It alerts the pilot of any radar signals that are detected, allowing the pilot to take appropriate actions. Radar warning receiver is a passive system that does not emit any signals, but it is an important component of ECM because it allows the pilot to take evasive action. Chaff and flare dispenser are another type of electronic countermeasure systems that are typically located on the sides of the aircraft. Chaff are small lightweight metal strips that are designed to reflect radar signals, creating a large number of false targets that can make it difficult for an enemy radar system to accurately track the fighter jet. Flares, on the other hand, produce a heat signature that can divert heat-seeking missiles away from the aircraft. Jamming pods are external pods that can be attached to the wings or fuselage of a fighter jet, which emit electronic signals to interfere with enemy radar and communication systems. These jamming signals can disrupt or deceive enemy electronic systems, making it more difficult for them to accurately track or target the fighter jet. Then there are infrared jammers as well. Infrared jammers are typically located on the tail of a fighter jet, where they can cover the most vulnerable areas of the aircraft from incoming missiles. When an infrared jammer is activated, it emits infrared signals that can confuse or deceive the missile's guidance system, making it less accurate or causing it to lose track of the target. There is also an advanced ECM system, known as electronic attack system. It is typically integrated into the avionics system of a fighter jet and can be controlled by the pilot or a dedicated electronic warfare officer. Some fighter jets, such as the A-18 Growler, are specifically designed for electronic warfare and have specialized pods and antennas that are used for electronic attack missions. Electronic attack system is a more advanced ECM system that can detect and track enemy electronic signals and then use jamming signals to disable or deceive them. Speaking of EA-18 Growler, it is an electronic warfare aircraft that is based on the F-18 Super Hornet fighter jet. It is designed to disrupt, deceive, and disable enemy radar and communication systems using a variety of electronic warfare techniques, including jamming and spoofing. It is equipped with advanced electronic attack systems, including jamming pods, radar warning receivers, infrared jammers, and other electronic countermeasure systems in order to provide critical support to other fighter jets and ground forces in modern combat operations. A critical component of this jet is the ALQ-99 tactical jamming system, which is used to jam enemy radars, reducing their effectiveness. It uses a digital radio frequency memory to record and replay radar signals, which allows it to generate false targets and deceive enemy radars. Though the range is classified information, but generally operates at a range that is within the range of enemy's radar system. It is capable of providing electronic attack support for both land-based and maritime operations. All these electronic countermeasure systems are used with one another or in combination so that the fighter jet can increase its chances of evading enemy threats.